Here we go, top of the hour. You're watching CNN. I'm Brooke Baldwin. Another member of the president's inner circle is out. White House. Bannon gets the door. Mm-hmm. What does this mean for the presidency? Mm.
So obviously there's two scenarios here. You allude to sort of in the Oval Office with Donald Trump, one representing that Breitbart wing of Trump's voter base. One, Reince representing and speaking to and for the establishment.
On the screen where you see
8 months into his first term.
I think we left the can you imagine train a while ago.
But here's the reason why Bannon gave his resignation letter on August 6th was that that's the same time the president said McMaster's my guy. And there was
Steve Bannon had this conversation with this incredibly progressive outlet and, you know, totally contradicted the president on saying there is no military solution, which obviously ticked off the commander in chief. Mm-hmm. Gianno, to you, how are we supposed to interpret this sense of war? I mean, mm-hmm. how much to the I think it was a New York Times reporter yeah. tweet saying, OK, no Biggs, he's just going to be on the phone with him, whispering into his ear instead of face to face. Or might he be, to borrow a phrase, you know, weaponized?
Yeah.
Once he leaves Trump.
I mean, well, there was a report. Reuters had a report that President Trump or somewhere else and try to weaponize and bring his agenda back to the forefront. And even if that conflicts with where the president goes.
Is this also, let me add this other layer of possibility. And again, one could argue that this is all strategery within the White House or just totally not. Okay. But right. The notion that we aren't in this moment, Tim, talking about Charlottesville. I mean, we alluded to it a second ago, but, you know, you have all these prominent Republicans coming out, Newt Gingrich being the latest, condemning the president for his response. But yet we're really now talking about, or most people are saying, pat on the back, Bannon's gone.
I suspect that, look, the president, that was, in my estimation, an exit interview.
Right.
That was him,
was
laying,
that him planting the seeds?
Laying the ground to come out of this a winner. Because he can argue, and he laid the ground. You want to know what it is? You just read that interview.
Gianno, do you agree? Do you feel like that more organizations have pulled out, massive organizations have pulled out of these events at Mar-a-Lago, the president's Florida's resort? We'll have that for you. More of the discussion. Stay with me on this crazy, crazy Friday afternoon. Back, you're watching CNN. I'm Brooke Baldwin. Back with our breaking news. Steve Bannon has been fired. It has been a chaotic 4 weeks. Even by these White House standards. So let's just all take a moment, just remind you what has happened, incredibly significant events, one after the other. So in no particular order.
We are in a very, and I'm not here to lecture because, by the way, I'm not a Civil War expert. I have colleagues who are. I had to learn about it, of course.
Forgive my rudeness as I just okay. jumped in.
No,
this
Shannon.
This is Shannon Lanier, and you are the, how many greats?
Sixth great-grandson of Thomas Jefferson and Sally Hemings.
Thomas Jefferson and Sally Hemings.
Yes.
You've listened to all of this. What do you think?
Yes, and your last...
Chuckled when I was asking David about, well, what does this mean? And he was like, well, let me just try to understand the why first. What do you think, a lot of people this week were saying in the wake of Charlottesville, get him out, this will be so much better, but will it be?
Well, remember what General Kelly said when he came in to be the chief of staff. His job is to control the staff. But the net result is that that General Kelly, done at the staff level at the White House, they don't need to have people kind of fighting with each other all day long, not kind of, but actually fighting with each other. They need to get their work done, and I think General Kelly's clearing out the brush so that the new shoots can come up.
What did you think, Jamila, just about this tweet from the Breitbart editor, War? I mean, do you think, depends on your perspective, that this is bad news for the president, that he'll harbor some ill will toward the same sort of characters like H.R. McMaster and others who he was feuding with and just bring it on the outside? What does that mean? We love seeing all these different hero stories. If you'd like to learn more about Michelle's full story and the dogs, or if you know someone phenomenal, we really encourage you to please nominate a hero. Just go to CNNHeroes.com. And on that note, I've been checking my Twitter. It has been a wild day indeed. If you want to tweet me, just send me a tweet at BrookeBCNN. I am the same on Instagram. Love the feedback, everything about it. I'm Brooke Baldwin. Thanks for being with me. Let's go to Washington. The Lead with Jake Tapper starts right now.